After a great weekend of college football championship games, the college football playoffs is set, and boy oh boy are people mad. Michigan claimed the first overall seed in the college football playoffs after their win over Iowa and ultimately the best season in college football. Their resume included wins over Ohio State, Penn State, Iowa, and they were the clear-cut number one here. At number two, we have Washington. They also had an incredible season. Most people picked them to lose this game against Oregon, and against all odds, they upset them here to win the Pac-12 championship, and Michael Penix Jr. has made a very strong case to win the Heisman Award. This is where things get pretty controversial here, folks. At number three, we have Texas. They obviously beat Oklahoma State to win the Big 12 championship. They defeated Alabama on the road earlier in the year. And once they were selected at number three, Florida State fans definitely started to panic as that fourth spot was open between them, Alabama, and Georgia. And my oh my, Alabama defeated Georgia in the SEC championship. Georgia, the team that's basically been number one overall for the past 3 years, lost and ultimately fell out of the college football playoffs, leaving this fourth spot up to Alabama. I have seen so many people upset that Alabama made it over Florida State, and I understand why people are mad. Florida State had an incredible season, 13-0. They won the ACC championship. They beat Louisville with a third-string quarterback. And the fact of the matter is, you gotta feel so bad for Jordan Travis and how Florida State's season ultimately fell short due to an injury. But at the end of the day here, folks, the College Football Playoff Committee did a phenomenal job. Now, I know that's a very controversial take here, but I truly believe that they put in the four best teams in college football. Now, I understand, I've heard all of the different takes that people have why Florida State should be in. The committee shows that they only care about a certain style of football. There's 21 other dudes that are also playing. Look at this SEC bias that the committee showed. Just stop. These are just such terrible takes. At the end of the day, you don't honestly believe that Florida State is a top four team in college football. Look at the criteria to make it. You have to be one of the four best teams in the country. And I can confidently say that they are not. When they had Jordan Travis, they absolutely were. But you look at when Tate Rodemaker came in against Florida, they were able to pull out this win in the swamp, but he only had 134 passing yards. He ended up getting injured. Brock Glenn, a true freshman, played in the ACC championship. This dude only had 55 passing yards and 8 completions against Louisville. This is just crazy here. I do think the circumstances would have been a lot different for Florida State. Say Tate Rodemaker came in and absolutely balled out against Florida. He stayed healthy and went crazy against Louisville. I do think that Florida State would have made it. But you look at these two quarterbacks and their inability to move the ball up and down the field, it pushes Florida State outside the top four. Now, not only do they not pass the eye test without Travis, they only had the 55th hardest strength of schedule. You look at Alabama, who passed them. Many people were upset that Alabama was over them as they had one loss. They had a patch where they didn't look great at the beginning of the year, where they were barely beating teams. But at the end of the day, Alabama has the 5th hardest strength of schedule. Their only loss comes to Texas, who is the 3rd best team in the country. And they just beat the number one team in the country, Georgia, who I think over the last 3 years, most people would have agreed that they were the best team in the country. Alabama is 4-1 against teams that are ranked inside the top 25. And people are saying, oh, well, they beat Auburn by Hail Mary. Listen, they were on the road in a rivalry game. Anything can happen in those types of games. It's a long season where teams are going to have close wins. You look at these last 2 weeks for Florida State, they just simply were not the same team without Jordan Travis. And I really do feel terrible for all the other guys that were on the team. But if you're the committee, you did an absolutely amazing job picking the four best teams in college football. I absolutely agree Georgia should not have made it. I think there's also been some people that were upset about that decision, as they were the number one team in the country virtually all year long, and they lost because they played in the SEC championship in a very close game. Georgia simply was not one of the four best teams in the country. You can take out the SEC bias. Alabama's been amazing the last few weeks. I personally think they're the best team in college football right now, and everybody saw the reaction Michigan had seeing that Alabama was going to get the number 4 seed. I can tell you right now, they are not happy that they're playing Alabama, because the Tide are coming. One of the reasons why I think the committee did such a great job this year is, unlike years past, you always have a typical blowout or a clear-cut favorite that's going to win. This year, 1-4, I confidently believe that any team can win the national championship. All of these games should be absolutely phenomenal, and Vegas agrees with no crazy spreads. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the best year that the college football playoffs has done their rankings, and I cannot wait for a 12-team playoffs. It's going to be phenomenal. In the 1-4 matchup, you have Michigan against Alabama. I personally think this is going to be a great matchup, but I got to take Nick Saban in the tie here. You look at Jalen Milroe, as the season's progressed, he's been one of the best quarterbacks in college football. His confidence is only growing. He's become a better passer, and he's so explosive with his legs. And this Alabama defense is also vicious. I can tell you right now, J.J. McCarthy, if Michigan wants to win this game, is going to have to beat them with his arm. They're not going to be able to use their two phenomenal backs in Blake Corum and Donovan Edwards to beat this Crimson Tide squad. With all that being said, Alabama will beat Michigan to make it to the championship game. And in the 2-3 matchup, we have Texas versus Washington. This should also be a phenomenal game. Quinn Ewers just had his best game of his collegiate career, and he's looked phenomenal coming off this injury. And on the other side, this Washington team might have the most explosive offense in all of college football. Michael Penix Jr. is going to be a top three candidate to win the Heisman Trophy Award. Rome Odunze, Jaden McMillan, Jalen Polk. How do you guard these guys? Dylan Johnson is also one of the most underrated running backs in the country. This offense can come at you in so many different directions. Their offensive line played absolutely phenomenal against Oregon. I'm super excited about this Washington team, and I think we're going to see two upsets happen in the college football playoffs. Even though Texas is the 3 seed, they're currently the betting favorite, and I'm taking Washington to win this game. I love what Michael Penix Jr. showed in the Pac-12 championship. He loves that underdog mentality, and this dude is going to get it done. So give me Washington and Alabama to play in the college football championship, where I do have Nick Saban and the boys ultimately beating the Huskies. I just think this Alabama team has been way too good these past few weeks, and the Georgia win was really what showed me they could do it. It's like betting against Tom Brady or Michael Jordan. I just simply can't do it against Nick Saban. People have been counting them out all season. Nick Saban's going to fire up his guys, saying that nobody believes you should be here right now. Nobody even believed in you guys to come this far. So give me the Alabama Crimson Tide to win the college football championship. I'm Caden Kubler, and that's my take.